The multi-level marketing coaching industry is a parasite that feeds on multi-level marketing, which in turn feeds off of society. So you've got a parasite on top of a parasite on top of society. So if you think about it, in multi-level marketing, most people, over 99% of people, are doomed to failure. They must lose in order for these scams to function, in order for a fraction of a percent of people to make a lot of money. And also integral to these scams is that the participants believe that their inevitable failure is their fault. That's why they're constantly working on themselves, personal development. They'll say it's like personal development with a paycheck. This industry is so beautiful. I've met this community of like-minded people and I just love these products. They've literally transformed my life. They attend Zoom meetings. They go to conventions. They do all this kind of training. These multi-level marketing companies brainwash them so well and they're so conditioned to believe that there's something wrong with them that it is so easy for somebody that's going to offer multi-level marketing specific coaching to give them the blueprint, the keys to success, to finally crack the code, to stop them from sabotaging themselves and become and get time and money freedom, and get the top of their compensation plan. A lot of these multi-level marketing coaches have been in MLM pyramid schemes, realizing that there's way more money to be made doing coaching. And they, because they can coach people in every multi-level marketing company, it's not just restricted to one MLM. And most people believe that there's something wrong with them. So they don't really need to work very hard to brainwash people who are already brainwashed. And the other part of this that's really brutal, it's not just money that's being spent in time, is that it's like this double indoctrination going on. So you're already in one multi-level marketing company, but then you get into this other intense coaching group or community potentially that can be, it's, you're surrounded by people in all different types of multi-level marketing companies. So you really feel part of this profession that you're going to be, you know, working even harder than others. You're chosen because you've chosen to invest in yourself, in this business. You're taking additional coaching. Not many other people are doing that. You're special. So not only are you doing all the work that you see all these multi-level marketing participants doing, but you're doing that again in these coaching groups, these coaching cults on top of it. This stuff can really take over your life. And that's what happened with me. So I've got like insight into this and this is why I speak out. So I wanted to show you this. I came across this article via one of these multi-level marketing coaching groups on Facebook. It's called The Game of Networking. The Game of Networking, a safe place for network marketers to collaborate. And you know what they say about the game of network marketing?
You win or you die.
There is no middle ground. So I just like scrolled through this group. 66,000 people in this group. The engagement is pretty low. And it's a public group. And I could see that there was, you know, sketchy stuff, sketchy advice being offered, but there. I'm working on a video right now about multi-level marketing coaches, and I found this group and then this post made in this group, and look at this advice that was given about saying no. No doesn't mean no when you're in multi-level marketing. Simon says, this multi-level marketing coach says that there's no such thing as no, there's just, it's not a bad prospect. That's somebody that's saying, no, I don't want to be involved in your multi-level marketing pyramid scheme. Leave me alone. It's just bad timing. They just need to be asked maybe a few years later. No does not mean no in multi-level marketing. They really believe this. So this is what they're coaching. And we all do the same stuff in every multi-level marketing company. Isn't that wild? No doesn't mean no. Yeah, you have to follow up with them. That's what we were coached in Rank Makers. The tagline was follow up until they die. You keep following up. We had a 4-day follow up. You'd be like, oh, maybe you didn't see my message. I'm just curious. Clearly this isn't a fit for you, but do you know anybody who may or may not be interested in earning some extra income on the side? If not, no big deal. We had a 4-day follow up. I think we had a 30-day follow up, a 60-day follow up, a 90-day follow up, and then it would just continue like that. You were supposed to follow up over and over and over again because no doesn't mean no. It's so messed up. And trying to talk to people still in multi-level marketing that might, you know, they still are friends with you. This has been, they don't see it. They don't see that there's anything wrong with this. They do the same like mental gymnastics that we all do when we're in MLM to explain away why this is so problematic. It is disgusting. The belief that no doesn't mean no is foundational to multi-level marketing. It's a belief that when you're in MLM, everybody just accepts this as reality, as the truth. And so you have these multi-level marketing coaches, these two in particular that I'm referencing. One has 91,000 followers, one has 66,000 followers all on Facebook, and they coach this belief system, like this is the right way to do business, this is the right way to conduct yourself, disrespecting people saying no, and continuing to harass them. But they frame it in this way that, well, I'm actually serving you. It's so messed up. See, if you think of how many thousands of people across multi-level marketing, it doesn't matter what company they're in, they're being taught this and they don't even realize that there's anything wrong with this. This is the grip that MLMs have on people's minds.
There's a link to this article. This article was endorsed in this group as being, you know, has really good advice for people in network marketing. And it's so funny because it was released April this year, 2024, and it's like ancient. The scripts, it's about overcoming objections, and it gives you all these scripts that you can use as if this is going to be so powerful to grow your network marketing business. These scripts are so stupid. They're stilted, they're stale, they're outdated, and they don't work. And I wanted to show you a few of them and debunk them, especially if you've been in you're in multi-level marketing. Maybe you're starting to like wake up, you're on your way out, you're trying to like piece together, what have I been a part of? Why does this not make sense? You're starting to see the contradictions. And it can be helpful to have someone point them out. But these scripts are written by people who probably never use them. These are familiar to me. And they probably stretch back all the way back to Dexter Yeager and Amway, as far as I know. I don't know. Top 17 objecting responses from prospects and how to overcome. What this is referring to is predominantly sending out cold messages, like you're just sending out messages on Facebook or Instagram to people, strangers you don't know, saying, would you be open to taking a look at my product? If not, no big deal. Would you be open to making, do you keep your options open when, you know, looking to make some extra money on the side? If not, no big deal, that kind of thing. And then, or if you're just having like, you know, just like a casual conversation, totally authentic in the grocery store or at Target, complimenting somebody on their shoes. Then seeing if they'd like to meet your mentor, that kind of thing, you know? So when you're having these authentic conversations with people, when you get an objection, like saying, is this a pyramid scheme? or just no, how you can overcome that. So I'm not going to go through all of them. There's 17, but then there's also like a list of all these bonus ones, but I just wanted to like pick out some of them to show you. One, I heard rumors about this company. So number 8, oh, that's too bad. It seems anything can be published on the internet these days. If you're open to learn more about what we really do, let me know. If not, it's totally cool. So first off, people aren't going to say, I heard rumors about this company. They're already going to go on Google. They're going to look it up. They're going to be, oh, I was on YouTube and I saw a video about this company. They're not going to say, I heard rumors about this company. And it's important because this is it shows how out of touch whoever wrote this article is. So the next part of this is, oh, that's too bad. It seems anything in bold. Anything can be published on the internet these days, like the truth or whistleblowers, testimonies, facts, statistics can also be published on the internet. But if it's in your multi-level marketing company, you got to use all bold, anything, to try to insinuate, to imply that the person that's, you know, they might not be wanting to tell you outright, like, I looked this up and it's a scam and I don't really know what to say to you. I just don't want to have this conversation anymore. They're trying to get out of it. You're misreading the social cues because you are hardwired now to overcome objections, and you are always going to be right. You're not listening. You're only listening to respond. You're listening to conquer. That's what you're doing. And it's coming across that way. And especially with the way this script is worded, look at this. Anything can be published on the internet these days. And it's true. The egregious health and income claims made by all multi-level marketing companies, unfortunately, are published on the internet. So it kind of works both ways. It's a weak response because you're insulting the person that you're having a conversation with by trying to demean them. It's never going to end well when you have a conversation and you start insulting someone who's saying they've got this information that's contradicting what you believe. These scripts aren't going to work for you. And I know that you know that. The next one is, let me talk to my spouse. This one is so funny. Perfect. Sounds great. We actually encourage you to do so. And when they give you the okay, we can help you get started and overcome. Insert their problem they mentioned, any problem they mentioned. Behind on bills, school loan debt, anything. So this is kind of like a subtle, but also an insult. When they give you the okay. So what this is meant to do, what they're going to teach you when they're telling you this script is that, well, people don't want to have, they want to feel empowered. So they're going to want to join you because you're going to be, you know, subtly reminding them that they need to ask their spouse for permission. When all this is, it's like a bludgeon. It's heavy-handed and it's just gross. You don't talk to people like this. Oh, when they give you the okay, then we can, like, that part alone is gross, but the second part of this is just equally gross. Any of their problem, any problem they have, your company with this script, whatever company you're with, that's what these multi-level marketing coaches do. Anything, name an MLM, put it in on the globe, spin it and just put your finger on it. That's the one. It's like, insert the problem. Whatever problem they said, insert it into the script. You're not listening. You're not helping. All you're trying to do is like get them by any means possible. So you insult them by saying when you get permission from your spouse, and then you manipulate them. You deceive them by saying any whatever problem you have, just insert it into here. And then we can help you out with that. Okay, the next one that I wanted to show you is, this sounds like one of those pyramid things. So this is important. So that's number 11. Nobody says that. You're never going to encounter that. You're going to encounter someone telling you this is a pyramid scheme. And they're probably going to send you a link to maybe the FTC's website. They might send you the link to the definition of a pyramid scheme, Canada's Competition Act, Section 55.1. Maybe they'll even copy and paste like a bit of a paragraph explaining the Koscot pyramid scheme test to you. They might try to like get you to critically think, but you're not going to get, is this one of those pyramid things? They're going to tell you it's a pyramid scheme. So that's the first thing. It needs to be important because you need to know what you're going to encounter when you're in a multi-level marketing company. And now it says, just curious, what do you mean by a pyramid thing? Can you imagine if you're either typing this out in a message or actually saying it, it's going to look fake as fuck. You don't even know the definition of a pyramid scheme according to Canada or the US. You're going to say something ridiculous like my MLM isn't a pyramid scheme because pyramid schemes are illegal. That's not the definition of a pyramid scheme. You're going to say my MLM isn't a pyramid scheme because we sell products. It's called a product-based pyramid scheme. The FTC has shut those down. Do you know that? No. Because you're not being taught that. That's why this script is going to fail miserably as well. So it's like, this is what I think is really funny too, is what they point out in this. So they say that this prospect, just curious, what do you mean by a pyramid thing? Most can't even explain it and it is merely an assumption. So that's incorrect. Most people can explain it. I can explain it to you, but you can't explain to me what a pyramid scheme is. That's the problem. Most people try to explain it to you, but you don't listen because you're not listening to listen. You're listening to respond. You're listening to be combative. You're listening to conquer. You're listening to recruit. You're not listening to listen. You don't know the definition of a pyramid scheme. And so it's just so funny to me that this is, it's not funny. It's sad that this is on here. And then it says, sure is. This is the second option. You ready to start at the top of your own and get to work? Let me know if that line has ever worked on anyone. It won't work. It's pathetic. Okay, the next one I wanted to show you is, don't trust MLMs. That's too bad. I'm just curious. Did you have a bad experience? Or are you just basing it off hearsay or what you found on the internet? See, this is really desperate. So the first one is that, are you basing it on your experience? So if that person is just like, you're not listening to them, they're basically telling you no,
but you don't want to take their no, because no doesn't mean no in network marketing. No means not right now. We don't respect people who say no. It's like, it's just not the right time for them yet. So when you say, if you ask this question, it's like, is it based on your experience? Because then what you're going to counter with is that, well, our MLM is different. Any problem that you've had, you're just going to plug it and insert it into another script, even if it's a lie, because you're taught this. That's what you're taught to do in these scripts. My multi-level marketing company is different. Our culture is better. Our company just said they would never change to an affiliate model. Then they have this other where it's like, or are you just basing it off hearsay? Or are you following the FTC's recommendations to talk to past distributors? Which then I would counter with, are you encouraging participants not to follow FTC's guidelines, recommendations when they're doing their own research to sign up with an MLM? Are you advising people to go against the FTC? And if you are, in this regard, already so early on, before somebody has even signed up or tried a product, what else are you willing to ignore that, like, advise them to ignore the FTC on? This is where you're going. It's very tricky territory that these, what you're being coached on isn't what's happening in reality. And the last part of this is, or what you found on the internet. It's like, if somebody is finding additional information, they're like, shamed, you're taught to like shame and disparage, demean them, insult them, instead of like, good, go out and find more information. I want you to critically think, to make an informed decision. But when you're in a multi-level marketing company, it's about restricting access to information, gatekeeping it. You can only get the truth from me, and that's a problem. Anything else that runs counter, anything negative, is wrong. Anybody can publish anything on the internet. Well, and that's true with multi-level marketing as well. The egregious health and income claims that multi-level marketing companies make. Truthinadvertising.org had just published an article earlier this year. 98% of all multi-level marketing companies make fake, false, misleading income claims. 98%. That's abysmal. And yet, they're still going on. So it's like, you're right. Anybody can actually publish anything on the internet. It runs both ways. Okay. The next one I wanted to show you. This is one. Number 10. I don't know if it will work for me. So the reason why I wanted to read number 10 is I don't think anybody says that, but this response is standard. Let me ask you this. Are you coachable? If anybody ever asks you, in multi-level marketing, are you coachable? You're going to be asked this. Just run. This is the biggest red flag. If I could name one red flag in all of multi-level marketing, with all of the shit that I've been through, all of the interviews, all of the thousands of hours of content I've made, both while in multi-level marketing and then it's like added with like me speaking out, it's the word coachable. It's that bad. This thing, it's like I've described it as you're inviting the vampire into your house. They're like, can I come in? And you're like, yes. And they're like, perfect, I got you. It's that dangerous. What it signals is that you are giving over your autonomy to the cult. Because you have to remember, when you're in a multi-level marketing company, you get brainwashed. You believe that there's something wrong with you, that you constantly need to work on yourself. And not everybody has the exact same experience. You know, I think that we're past the point now that you can be like, oh, my experience wasn't identical to yours. It's like, yes, we get it. But a cult is a cult. You can be like right in the inner circle. You can be out on the fringe. It's like, we understand that. At least I hope we do. I hope this conversation has like gone to this point right now. And if not, I'm doing a swift kick up the ass to like move this conversation along. By saying, asking somebody if they're coachable, that means you're not at the top of your multi-level marketing pyramid scheme. You have something to work on then. So that means whoever is asking you that question, you're like giving your autonomy over to. They can tell you what to do. They can see what you need to do better than you can because they have something that you don't yet. Therefore, you don't have the right to critically think or question. And that can also keep you in for years. Are you coachable is such a big red flag. Now, to counter this, I made my own presentation for people that are getting prospected and getting beleaguered with people sending them DMs, and then you're trying to like say no, and they won't respect your no. They keep trying to overcome your no. So I made this for you. Number one, this is something that you're going to experience if you're in multi-level marketing and you talk to somebody who has been watching anti-MLM content. They're going to say MLMs are cults. So in these top 10, 17 objecting responses to overcome blah, 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 this massive word salad of a title, which is just clunky as all get out too, they didn't even address cults. This is probably going to be something you hear more and more about. And the more defensive you get about it, the more you're going to illustrate how it is a cult. So someone's going to say to you, MLMs are cults. So what we can say as well, you know, if you're the person that is going to have this conversation with somebody in your DMs, you can say, I'm just curious. Are you familiar with the BITE model? This is like the anti-MLM, how to like counteract the overcoming objections presentation, if you will. And if they get defensive, you can say, I know exactly how you feel. I felt the same way. How on earth could this be a cult? But what I found is that by being unable to critically think, viewing everyone outside MLM as a hater is a clear indicator you're in a cult. Another thing that you're going to encounter is MLMs are pyramid schemes, not is this a pyramid thing? It's going to be MLMs or pyramid schemes. So then when they say, oh no, what do you mean by that? Or some ridiculous script, then you can say, how do you define a pyramid scheme? If they bristle, ask them, according to Canada's Competition Act, Section 55.1, and if you're in the US, the Koscot pyramid scheme test, all MLMs are pyramid schemes. This may or may not be something you're interested in. Third one can counter with is FTC questions. Now, this is a good one. And I've got links to these questions and where I got this from, the FTC site. And I've got a lot of other links in the description below this video and other videos. So you can do your own research. You can say to the person trying to overcome your objection, I'm just curious, would you be open to me following the FTC's suggested questions before I make a decision? And this is important. Because what is somebody going to say in multi-level marketing? No, you should ignore the FTC. So if yes, now these are some of the questions that you can now ask the person in multi-level marketing that is trying to overcome your objections. And like I've said, I've linked this below so you can take a look at this. How much money did you make last year after expenses? What were your expenses last year? How many people have you recruited? How many did you recruit last year? How many of your recruits have left the business? And how people respond in multi-level marketing is going to be quite telling, because they're not going to be able to answer any of these. They're going to be defensive, antagonistic, and it's going to have some of that passive aggressive insult going on as well. But this is actually recommended by the FTC. So they're going to have to be insulting the FTC while they're doing this. And that's playing with fire. That's going to be really casting a dark, stinky shadow on their own multi-level marketing company. That's not operating out of integrity. I've got more. I put 3.1 for more FTC questions because the section was so good. There's even more, but I just included some of these on this presentation that took me all night to make just for you. What percentage of the money you made, income and bonuses, less your expenses, came from recruiting other distributors and selling them inventory or other items to get started? How much time do you spend on the business? If they are evasive, accusatory, try to deflect you from asking these questions. Ask them, I totally understand. Tell me, are you advising me to ignore the FTC's recommendations in regards to MLMs? You're probably not going to get this far in this hypothetical conversation, but we're having fun. Four, saying no. Now, this could be if you just say no to someone and someone says to you, do you mean no, not right now, or no, like forever, LOL? That's a common one. So remember, saying no is a complete sentence. You can write that in. No is a complete sentence. It's horrible that we need to do that. However, when you're dealing with people in an MLM cult, they are taught that no doesn't mean no, it means not right now. You could say to them, what is it about me saying no that makes you so uncomfortable? I'm just curious, why are you using scripts to try and overcome my objections instead of listening to what I'm telling you? Why are you using? I made a spelling mistake. You have to have a token spelling mistake in one of these presentations. And there you go. That's what I have to say about that. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.
There comes a day when I'll be the one you see. It's gonna be me.